stood on the corner of 14th Street watching the demolition of this church. The old West Side Church was being reduced to a parking lot. Indignities of modern architecture. I was here to watch the destruction and take notes for my college term paper about the historic building and the incident that occurred here in the late fall of 1955. Little did I know at that time they weren't just tearing down the church. They were unleashing 25 years of suppressed evil. Just going through these old papers, trying to find an idea for a term paper. Want to help?
No, thanks. I got a paper I have to turn in to Mr. White.
Okay, I'll see you later.
Here are the pictures of the church.
I got a story to put that on the funny page.
Look, it said that the victims were cut with a sharp object rather than a knife. No motives, no leads, nothing to catch the murderer by.
Mark, what have you been smoking?
This first case is almost identical to the murder last night. Look, it's almost word for word the same.
Why don't you be sensible? The guy killed people over 20 years ago. He would be 50 years old by now.
I bet he killed him with a hook.
If you really want to know, why don't you go to the county clerk's office and find out? Just look up the girl's relatives and I'm sure they can tell you anything you want to know.
You think they'd have any information on those girls?
The only way you're going to find out is if you go and check.
Yeah. I just might do that. And I'll show you I'm right.
Just don't get them pissed at you.
Oh, you scared me. I didn't think anyone was home. Are you Frank Morgan?
Yeah.
My name's Mark Hampton. You probably don't know me. I was interested in the old Hookman killings back in 55. Do you know anything about those? Look, I was doing a paper on them, and I was just wanting to know if you'd give me any information.
I understand it if you don't want to talk to me. Just, I'm pretty curious as to those killings back then.
I can understand it if you're, if you don't want to talk about it, that's okay. You're just the only one I can find any leads off of right now.
It all started back in 53. Start with the Anderson girls. Turned up missing. Found them 3 days later. The meat locker. Corner grocery store. Little tiny pieces. Funny thing about them, though. Never had a good reason for killing anybody. Never gave the police any clues. Newspaper started calling him the Hookman, because he's the hook from the lock-in prison. Few more killings after that. Finally caught him about 54. Had the trials right here in town. Found him crazy. Took him up some mental institution up in Evanston. But the families didn't think that was enough.
What happened then?
Sylvan went up there and secretly stole them one night. Then they took them down to the old church. So then they walled them up. So they sure the evil couldn't escape.
How'd you know all this?
Well, I helped wall them up.
Did you hear they tore down the church on 14th?
Guy that wrote this story?
Yeah.
My name's Mark Hampton, and I think I have a story for you.
Let's hear it.
My sister doesn't even believe me. Now, I haven't gone to the police yet, because I know they won't believe me. But what do you think?
Well, I think you're crazy. But not totally crazy.
That's what everyone tells me. What do you mean, not totally crazy?
Well, suppose someone else got a hold of those papers and decided to pattern their killings after the killings of a criminal who to them might be a hero. Most criminals like attention.
What about the timing between the church being torn down and the murder?
What you're trying to say is the guy's ghost is going around killing these people? Come on, be realistic.
Outside of 1020 Elm Street, where only hours before, police discovered the torn and mutilated body of Kathy Fields. This is the second murder case this week involving a torn and mutilated body in Coles County. Police are baffled, but one investigator told me privately that these are the most bizarre murder cases he has ever experienced. Christine Boats, WAND News, reporting.
Thanks, Boats. That's our news tonight. Thank you very much for joining us. Have a good weekend. Good evening.
Good night.
of the senseless murders being similar to the forgotten ones in 55. I couldn't take this old church off my mind. There had to have been a connection. Had the dormant evil miraculously escaped? Anyway, I knew then what my term paper was going to be written about. So I began.
Everybody, I got a name! Mom! Dad! Becky? Anyone home? No one cares. I got an A on the old Hookman story. I got an A. Look, I got an A. An A. Crap.
Yep, this is the Hookman's house. It's been for sale since 1955. Hasn't sold in 25 years.
How come?
Now there's rumor around here that this place is haunted.
By the Hookman, of course.
Of course. By the way, I found out who the Hookman was before he was the Hookman. His name was Wendell North. They called him Junior.
Wendell North, huh? How do you know all this?
Well, most of it's reporter's job's research. I covered all the angles I could find. You heard what I found out.
In other words, you're not going to tell me, huh?
You got it.
It's cold.
It's getting that way. I told you they wouldn't believe us.
I suppose they do. They're just trying to keep clear of a panic in the town.
Well, it's possible. But I'd explain why they took all our old photographs and newspapers.
You know, that police chief didn't believe a damn word we said. He just thinks we're out for publicity. You know that, don't you?
Yeah, that's the way they always are.
You know, it's funny. Knowing someone that's alive one minute, dead the next.
What do you mean?
The two girls. You know, the ones that the Hookman killed.
You knew them?
Not very well. It was in history class.
Well, what's worse when you have to go to the scene of the crime for the newspaper and write, do a story on it?
I don't remember if I went to the bathroom or not.
How did you drive home?
You can do anything if you put your mind to it.
You know you have to get up at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Yeah. have to be a creative person. Gotta have an imaginative mind.
Why don't you imagine yourself going to bed and getting some sleep?
The power of the mind has been known to work miracles.
Right.
Becky? I love you.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm going over to Dan's house.
And leave me here all alone?
Where's Mom and Dad?
Dad went on a business trip. Mom went with him.
Hey, you want to go with me?
No, I got some homework to do.
I thought maybe you might want to meet Dan. Well, I'm going to lock the door behind me, all right?
Yeah, please do.
This is information I've never seen before. Where'd you get it?
Mayor's private library. You know, I've got connections uptown, like I told you. You might want to check out that newspaper there. It's got some stuff you've probably never seen before either.
Has this got articles that, about the trial?
It's taken the picture in there a couple days before the trial, and the article came out a day before the trial.
This is Wendell North?
Yep, that's him. Kind of funny looking. Strange old guy.
He didn't look anything like I pictured him.
Well, most people had different views of what he looked like. He was running around for those years killing people and with no clues. Everybody thought up some really gruesome idea of what he ought to be. He didn't fulfill their dreams.
Doesn't look much like a killer to me.
Story. Move it over two columns. Insert that one about Mrs. Bright's social party she's having. Yeah, you know the one. Boring one, right? You gotta stick it in there.
Yeah. Now save that lifestyle piece for next week. We're gonna have to make room for this other stuff.
Okay, yeah, finish out, move the rest of those layouts around. I'll check it out when I get there tomorrow. Right, bye.
Tonight. Let's hope not.
I checked the bathrooms.
Don't do that.
Like I was saying, I checked the bathrooms. There's no one in there.
I can't find anybody back here. Let's go get the rest of this, man.
Well, what are we going to do now?
I don't know about you, but I got to go out to the car.
What for?
Get the bullets, I forgot.
You mean we've been walking around this house with no bullets in that gun, and he's in here some... Oh. Look, I'm sorry. I'm upset, all right?
It's all right. It's cool. Just calm down.
All right. It's all right, Becky. It's okay. It's all
hotshot coppers out here. Last time I called you guys, got here too late, and those guys got off with my cows. Now, there's a prowler in the barn. I need somebody out here right now. Yeah, real route 3. I'm the only house sitting around here for 2 miles. You guys don't hurry up. I'm going to take care of this myself.
Dan's going around thinking that it's just some kind of crazed killer. Looking for some kind of clues as to where he's at. I'm going around thinking it's a ghost. The police think it's some loony out just to get his fun killing people. Let me tell you something. No one's right. All of us are wrong. I know who the killer is now. You want to know who he is? You're looking at him. It's me.
What?
It's me.
What? Mark, you're crazy. You're absolutely crazy. I don't know what the heck you're talking about. Look at this. It's crazy.
Think about it. Look who he's killed. He's killed everyone that I've been in contact with, or I know. What did he look like tonight when you saw him in the house? What did the killer look like? Was he fat, tall, short?
He was short, he had a small build, he was wearing glasses, and he had dark hair. That's what he looked like. And he had a hook, and that's all that matters.
Wendell North was big and tall. He wasn't thin. He was what I created him to be. He was something that was in my mind. He tried to kill you. Think about it. I wanted there to be a hookman so bad, okay? I wanted there to be a hookman so bad that I created one. You can believe me if you want, but it is true. And if I can help it, I'm going to stop another murder tonight.
Match in, car 30.
Car 30, go ahead.
1020, car 30.
Be at the 1400 block of Broadway.
10-4, I report of a prowler to Frank Morgan residence, handle code 30.
10-4, Matt Toon, be handling code 30, 1076.
Mr. Morgan, that you up there? Morgan, you all right?
Do you really understand what happened? Do you understand what's been happening all along?
No. No, I guess I don't.
There were only two other people out there when Frank Morgan and the policeman were killed. Just me and Mark. How do you think Mark knew Frank Morgan was going to be killed?
Becky, you've told me this 100 times.
I know. But you've got to understand. You know how people move objects with their minds? Without using any kind of physical force other than thought?
Sure. Parlor tricks.
Yeah, that's what I used to think when I was too damn stubborn to listen to anything else. Look, Mark has the same kind of power, only instead of moving objects, he created one in his subconscious. And the police can come over here as many times as they want. And you can call that psychiatrist and have Mark go there as many times as you can afford. But it isn't going to stop the murderer!
Shut up, Becky, just shut up!
So then they walled him up. They walled him up to be sure that evil couldn't escape.
By the way, I found out who the Hookman was before he was the Hookman. His name was Wendell North. They called him Hughes.
Wendell North. What do you think about him, though?
Never had a good reason for killing anybody. Never gave the police any clues. Newspapers started calling the Hookman. He's been hooked from the lock-in prison.